I'm Call Me Charisma, and this is me going track by track through my new EP, The Gloomy Tapes, Volume 1. Angel is a song I wrote about growing up in a home with my mother, who is battling alcoholism. Everyone goes through shit, and I know a lot of people can relate to what I said in that track, so I thought it'd be good to start the album with that. Goddamn It is a song about me being on the road touring and having a girl back home and fucking up a lot and her still loving me for some reason. And it was kind of me being like, goddamn it, like, how can you still love me? You're so perfect and I'm just, you know, a mess up. Rockstar is a song I wrote over a year ago now, and it's me kind of saying what I wanted from the start. Like, I want to be a rock star, have money, clothes, and hoes, you know, like that whole thing. But it turned into less about that and more about me advocating for what I believe in. Johnny is about a mentally ill kid who does some fucked up shit. And I wrote that because I'm very passionate about that. I deal with mental issues as well. I just think it's a light that needs to be shed on something that doesn't get enough. Like, these kids need help and they're not getting it. And I think it can lead to terrible events like school shootings and shit. So I just wanted to speak on that. The final song is called Let Me Go. It's about from the time I wrote my first song when I was 10 years old to 22 and playing headline shows across the country. And it was just kind of showing my growth, and it was kind of to my parents saying, yo, like, let me go, let me do this shit, like, I can prove you and a bunch of people wrong, and it's all love, you know. So that, I thought that was a great outro to the first EP, so I think you guys are gonna fuck with it. This is my life, no filters. Here we go.
Mommy, wake up, I got school in an hour and I still need breakfast. Say some. I hate when you mumble, please come to your senses. This Coca-Cola got you tripping over onto the kitchen counter. Can you drink some water now? I miss you, Mom. Every night I sing this song. If I were an angel, I could fly away from here. I'm surrounded by strength. Just how I feel. Both of my wings broke, I can't seem to fix them. All these happy pills won't listen. If I were an angel, I could finally disappear. I can't think straight. Been in school for an hour and I haven't learned shit. I replay thoughts of my parents fighting, but I'm who they're hurting. Motorola got me texting, knowing I'll be all alone forever. Someday maybe I'll be with you, Mom. Till then I'ma sing this song. If I were an angel, a God, why'd he make me? All of these flaws is all that I see. If there's a God, I don't believe someone as perfect as you would love me. God damn it. Praying to a ghost, hoping he gets it. My last three girls I fucked didn't listen. The last two pills I took haven't kicked in. Having these one night stands with addiction. Now I gotta catch a red eye to Michigan. Playing a show than a girl that I'm getting with. Fuck it, I'm young, I can act like an idiot. How many sins I gotta make till I get the hint?
If there's a God, why'd he make me? All of these flaws is all that I see. If there's a God, I don't believe someone as perfect as you would love me. God damn it.
Baby, you're a ghost, why are you missing? Maybe cause I haven't hit you back in a minute. Maybe cause I flirt with every girl in existence. I blame it on distance, that I'm being distant. But I don't fucking care, I gotta sing to these kids quick. I remember never having fans that would listen. Now I got 1,000 every city I visit. It's just that you ain't here now when I miss it. But shit, it's 4 a.m, pouring rain. I'll board again, so I break down. Go insane, more than hate now, now.
Yeah.
I fucked up, course I did. The more I think, now I should quit, forfeit the crown. I give this up to not let you down again.
If there's a God, why'd he make me? All of these flaws is all that I see. If there's a God, I don't believe someone as perfect as you would love me. God damn it.
I said, mama, I'm a rock star. I'ma drive a sports car. I'ma be on TV. See me on the Forbes chart. Mama, I'm a rock star. Stay up till the moon sleeps. Get the baddest girls like they do in all the movies. Mama, I'm a. I don't wear baggy jeans. Skinny black, give me 20 pants with the knees ripped. I love Jesus, but got these bitches know how to dance. And I don't care about anything. Play me hard. Baby, break my heart. I don't need ya. I got a visa. Swipe 3 times, it'll take you far. Okay, okay, I guess I'm a mess. No one told me fame would be like this. I used to be called a fucking bitch. Now every night I can fuck your bitch. No one said I'd be here on my own. No one used to text me on my phone. Now they wanna guess this to my show. I guess it shows.
I said, mama, star. I'ma drive a sports car. I'ma be on TV. See me on the Forbes chart. Mama, I'm a rock star. Stay up till the moon sleeps. Get the baddest girls like they do in all the movies. Mama, I'm a rock star. Rock star. Mama, I'm a rock star. Mama, I'm a rock star.
By a girl I don't know, she's a 10. I'm in bed, getting head from the floor. Always stressed when on tour. Get a check, make it 4. Taking meds, take some more. Sick of sex, but I'm bored. Okay, okay, I guess I'm a dick. No one told me fame would be like this. I used to be called a fucking bitch. Now every night I can fuck your bitch. No one said I'd be here on my own. No one used to come out to my shows. Now they wait in line out in the cold. I guess it shows.
Said, mama, I'm a rock star. I'ma drive a sports car. I'ma be on TV. See me on the Forbes chart. Mama, I'm a rock star. Stay up till the moon sleeps. Get the baddest girls like they do in all the movies. Mama, I'm a rockstar.
Mama, I'm a rockstar. Mama, I'm a rockstar. Mama, I'm a rockstar. Mama.
May 25th, 2018. Another school shooting happened today. One will probably happen again next week and the week after that. I am no politician. I am not a lawmaker or a judge or a person of authority. I am no longer a student. I am not a teacher nor a parent. I am an artist. And I believe my job as an artist is to create music to open the listener's mind in the few minutes that they're hearing my song. I don't promise to always say the right things or be politically correct. I don't know enough about guns or what laws might prevent the next murder of an innocent child. There are millions of these people already protesting our current laws, so I decided to speak on something I'm more familiar with that will hopefully open up a dialogue to go hand in hand with gun violence talks. A topic I am familiar with is mental illness. Right now it is a devastating crisis affecting our youth. I've struggled with mental illness since I was young. I just thought I was the crazy kid. I kept to myself so others wouldn't know about my issues. I luckily learned to battle my illness by writing songs. It was my escape from it all. Unfortunately, in the last decade, since I was in middle school, I guess, I've seen our situation become incredibly worse. I can't go a few days without seeing a tweet or a Facebook post saying, "My friend killed himself today." As a society, we have ignored countless signs of mental illness and blanketed these issues with prescription pills and stigmas that only polarize these kids who need help the most. Then we sit on our couches and see headlines reading, "Record high teen suicide" and "Kid brings a weapon to class," then act shocked and make it seem like they're just born quote-unquote crazy. These kids need way more than a handful of fucking Xanax. I'm not here to excuse or condone any violence, but just to shed a light on society's passive role in creating a mind inside a kid to do such horrific things to their peers. Now, this is not a letter about a racist, radicalized adult walking into a school and killing children, or shooting up a church or a Denny's. There is no fucking excuse for that. There is no helping someone who wants to hurt innocent people, and they should never be forgiven. I'm writing this because today on the news I saw that a 12-year-old boy walked into a class and shot at his fellow students. No one was killed, but I turned off the TV and really asked myself, at 12, what was I doing? Was I at wrestling practice? Was I playing on my Game Boy? Maybe working up enough courage to talk to a girl in gym class? One thing that never crossed my mind was hurting myself or others. That doesn't mean that other kids don't go through these things and have these feelings. I think we need to take a step back and wonder what is really driving a boy who should be at band practice to want to die and take innocent classmates with him. I was advised not to speak on my song Johnny in this letter. I told my management team I was going to write it anyway. And I want to say a few things. Johnny is a 12-year-old boy, someone that you may know but have no idea what is going on in his head. Johnny could be a girl who comes home with cuts on her arms, but her parents tell her it's a phase and she's gonna grow out of it. Johnny could be your son that starts posting weapons on social media, but you just say, "Boys will be boys." Johnny could be your friend who gets called a slut and tells you she wants to die every day, but you ignore the signs. I'll say it again, there's no apologizing for a school shooter, but no boy hardly yet through puberty would ever do what Johnny did without being mentally ill and drastically affected in a negative way by our society. I was told that writing a song that speaks more from the shooter's perspective could be taken the wrong way, and that is why I wouldn't change a fucking word to this song. As a society in America, we have to understand that our job is to put our youth first and not to measure mental health on a crazy scale. Everything shouldn't be easy listening and viewing. Sometimes we need to know what could happen if we don't do something. I am no saint, and I am just as guilty as the next when it comes to turning a blind eye to this epidemic. We need to learn to talk with our kids and realize that regardless of what politicians put into law, we can make a difference without them. A difference that can change the impact of one or 1,000 lives, maybe more. Something as simple as, "How's your mental health today?" or, "I saw your tweet, are you doing okay? Let's talk about it." This song was meant to cause a stir. It was meant to upset people. It was meant to really put the pressure on us as a society to combat mental health, starting from preschool onward. I didn't have someone at my school to talk about my feelings, and I was afraid to talk to my friends about it. I want that to end. I want there to be unlimited resources available in every public school for kids to let it all out and to know it's okay to be sad, but it isn't okay to give up. Most importantly, I wrote this song without a happy ending, because there is no happy ending without us making a change. Before any law is put in place, or before any therapist is put into our schools, a shooting will happen again. I end this letter by saying this. I am no politician. I'm not a lawmaker, or a judge, or a person of authority. I'm no longer a student. I am not a teacher, nor a parent. I am a human being. And I wrote this letter to hopefully bring us together to civilly and quickly put our kids first and make mental illness a priority. I will make no apologies for this song. If it pisses off a million people, if it helps one kid know that their mental health is fucking important and their society is here to support them through it all, then it's worth every bit of hate. I'm going to do my best from here on out to listen. Your friend, Riz.
Teacher, teacher, can't tell me nothing. Only word I learned was dysfunction. Mom and daddy, you just don't get it. All the kids at school say I'm different. Johnny's got a loaded 45, found it in his dad's shoebox. Johnny doesn't want to be alive, but he's gotta make a school stop. He's sick of being bullied. His mother's starting to worry, but she doesn't wanna ask him or try to call the authorities. Now he is on the bus like it is just another morning, but he doesn't got a book, he's got a gun without a warning. Cindy's got a scholarship to Yale,
yeah.
Wants to be a nurse and spread love.
Help.
Cindy's moving out before the fall, only got a week till school's done. Taking every final is easy, she doesn't mind him. She's always nice to the kids that are coming and way behind her. She would never hurt a fire, bad and eye, she's way too kind. But then a flash and then a crying sees Johnny with a rifle.
Teacher, teacher, can't tell me nothing. Only word I learned was dysfunction. Mom and daddy, you just don't get it. All the kids at school say I'm different.
Johnny sees Cindy in the hall,
get the fuck,
runs to go get her by the hair.
Come here, bitch.
Cindy didn't want to be involved. Johnny says, stay the fuck here. Starts to hear sirens and everybody is crying. The police are outside and now Cindy's inside a closet. And she doesn't want to die, she's got a Bible in her pocket. But where the fuck is God when the world's getting way too violent? Eyes closed, praying for her life while the shots go. Screaming for the cops, but they're not close. She's not writing letters, but where's John Doe? He's right here. Grabs Cindy by her bright white hair. Says to be quiet or your life ends here. But the door breaks down and now John gets scared. So he puts the gun to her head. Life ain't fair. Let me tell you about my life quick. I'm the fucking shy kid. At the party, I'm the kid that never got invited. Had the one who failed every test, every problem. It's not fucking fair. You're in Yale for your college. Goddamn, my mom can't stand, she's drunk. Pop stands, I can't stand feeling numb. Stop moving, Cindy, you squeal too much. Pop goes the gun, another school shot up.
Teacher, teacher, can't tell me nothing. Only word I learned was dysfunction. Mom and daddy, you just don't get it. All the kids at school say I'm different.
Reporting live from high school, we're now learning more about the terrible events that took place and what could drive someone that seemed like a normal kid to do something so evil and inhumane. We are asking everyone and anyone that sees warning signs to please offer help and love and compassion to those who need it. Together, we can make a difference. Yeah. My mother cleans houses, dad works at a bank.
curse of that is people think my life is perfect. It ain't hurts me to say I felt I wasn't what they urged me to be. I was never what my brother was, I learned right away. At 10 I wrote my first song, at 12 recorded it all. It felt important at first, but honey Morgan, that's false. You gotta go to your room, say prayers while holding your palms. Forget this music is through, don't think you're getting involved. But mom, I'm older, it's cool, don't wanna go by your rules. I'm just a fucking outcast and no one knows me at school. I don't smoke, I don't drink, don't wanna grow to be you. Just let me go, I'm okay, be back to show you the proof.
Let me try, let me grow, let me live, but you won't let me go. Let me go. Step aside, let me show I can drive down this road. Let me go. Let me go.
I was 16 when I performed my first show. No one came with except the homie that drove. Fuck it, we're going alone. Got off stage, not a text on my phone. No congrats, no we're proud, no one to tell me I'm dope. 18, I moved out to school, I brought my notebook to write, hoping to jot a song a day and then record it at night. My parents told me I was finished, you won't tour in your life. You ain't bringing a thing to college, not a cord or a mic. But mom, I'm older, it's fine, fuck all these homework assignments. I've been dreaming of this, but I ain't closing my eyes. I don't smoke, I don't drink, I'm in my dorm every night. Just let me go, I'm okay, be back at home when it's time.
Let me try, let me grow, let me live, but you won't let me go. Let me go. Step aside, let me show I can drive down this road. Let me go. Let me go.
At 19, I lost hope, moved back to my mom's. I took a couple classes still just to have when I want. I tried everything I knew, every rap, every song, but nothing worked and no one saw the vision that I had brought. I checked my Twitter at noon, on lunch break at my shift. I read I'm going on tour, who should I take along with? I told my fans this is it, tweet them back, I'm the shit. The next day I got an email that I was picked. I fucking told you mom, I'm never coming back here. I'm touring 50 states in 60 days with Black Bear. Now I'm playing shows at 22 and I have fans here. Next year I'll be home, hope I see you and dad there. Yeah.